You may hear about a pyramid scheme from friends, family, or neighbors. Usually, pyramid schemes recruit members at seminars, home meetings, over the phone, by email, post, or social media. A pyramid scheme is a business model that recruits members via a promise of payments or services for enrolling others into the scheme, rather than supplying investments or sale of products. As recruiting multiplies, recruiting becomes quickly impossible, and most members are unable to profit. As such, pyramid schemes are unsustainable and often illegal. Pyramid schemes are illegal in many countries. Pyramid schemes have existed for at least a century in different guises. Some multi-level marketing plans have been classified as pyramid schemes. The model of profiting by using the network effect often traps individuals into recruiting their acquaintances, which can feel slimy for everyone involved and can ultimately strain relationships. In a typical pyramid scheme, you pay to join. The scheme relies on you convincing other people to join up and to part with their money as well. In order for everyone in the scheme to make a profit, there needs to be an endless supply of new members. In reality, the number of people willing to join the scheme, and therefore the amount of money coming into the scheme, will dry up very quickly. Pyramid schemes are so named because they resemble a pyramid structure, starting with a single point on top, that becomes progressively wider toward the bottom. Some pyramid scheme promoters disguise their true purpose by introducing products that are overpriced, of poor quality, difficult to sell, or of little value. Making money out of recruitment is still their main aim. The promoters at the top of the pyramid make their money by having people join the scheme. They pocket the fees and other payments made by those who join under them. When the scheme collapses, relationships, friendships, and even marriages can be damaged over money lost in the scam. It is against the law to promote or participate in a pyramid scheme. Action Fraud, the National Cybercrime and Reporting Center, says they've noticed a rise in so-called investment schemes being advertised on these channels. And people in their 20s, who may think of themselves as the most social media savvy, are most likely to fall victim. Cyber scam expert Scott McGreedy told BBC Scotland News, "Pyramid schemes are nothing new. They've been around since the early 1900s. It's just reskinned and remade for a new platform and a new audience. We don't know how common they are because people are not coming forward and saying it happened to them. People don't tend to report it because they feel a bit stupid, a bit silly. But that's not the case. This type of fraud is prevalent, especially on social media." Warning signs. You are offered a chance to join a group, scheme, program, or team where you need to recruit new members to make money. The scheme involves offering goods or services of little or doubtful value that serve only to promote the scheme, such as information sheets. There are big upfront costs. The promoter makes claims like, "This is not a pyramid scheme," or "This is totally legal." Fraudsters frequently promote pyramid schemes through social media, internet advertising, company websites, group presentations, conference calls, YouTube videos, and other means. Pyramid scheme promoters may go to great lengths to make the program look like a business, such as a legitimate multi-level marketing or MLM program. But the fraudsters use money paid by new recruits to pay off earlier stage investors, usually recruits as well. At some point, the schemes get too big. The promoter cannot raise enough money from new investors to pay earlier investors, and people lose their money. When fraudsters attempt to make money solely by recruiting new participants into a program, that is a pyramid scheme, and there is only one possible mathematical result: collapse. Imagine if one participant must find six other participants, who in turn must find six new recruits each. In only 11 layers of the downline, you would need more participants than the entire population of the United States to maintain the scheme. Pyramid schemes are viable as long as the lowest levels remain wider than the upper ones. But once the lowest levels shrink, the entire structure collapses. By nature of exponential math, it's just plain impossible for pyramids to sustain forever, and somewhere in the chain, people will invariably lose their money. Interestingly, even high-level early adopters may lose money near the end due to conditions that delay their payments from underlings, which often require waiting periods. Types of pyramid schemes. Different forms of pyramid schemes exist, which can be broadly classified as follows. Chain emails. Chain emails persuade naive recipients to donate chunks of money to everyone listed within the email. After making the donations, the donor is invited to delete the first name on the list and replace it with his own, before forwarding the chain along to his own group of contacts, with hopes that one or more of them will send cash his way. In theory, recipients keep collecting donations until their name is deleted from the list. Multi-level marketing pyramid scheme. Multi-level marketing, MLM, is a legal business practice, but unlike traditional pyramid schemes, this model involves the sale of actual goods or services. But participants are not mandated to close any sales. To generate income, they must recruit members below them. Some MLMs are nearly indistinguishable from pyramid schemes because they involve the sale of printed materials that have no real value, such as educational courses. These MLM schemes thrive by forcing recruits to buy such no-value products at high costs, and by making them sell these same products to the next generational members. Ponzi schemes. Ponzi schemes are investment cons that work on the premise of robbing Peter to pay Paul. They may not necessarily adopt a pyramid scheme's hierarchical structure, but they do promise high returns to existing investors by taking investment money from new blood. Often lured by the prospect of too good to be true returns, most Ponzi participants end up losing everything. Investment advisor Bernard Madoff, arguably the most notorious Ponzi scheme artist, was sentenced to 150 years in prison for operating a multi-billion dollar illegal operation. Madoff died in prison on April 14, 2021. The SEC's Office of Investor Education and Advocacy has issued Investor Alert to warn individual investors about pyramid schemes, a type of investment scam that fraudsters often pitch as a legitimate business opportunity in the form of multi-level marketing programs. The SEC has taken emergency enforcement action to stop alleged pyramid schemes that violate the federal securities laws, including schemes disguised as MLM programs. For example, in a recently filed litigation, SEC v. CKB 168, the SEC filed charges to stop an alleged pyramid scheme perpetrated under the facade of an MLM program for online children's courses. The promoters of the scheme allegedly solicited investors worldwide, including targeting members of Asian American communities in New York and California. The SEC alleges that these promoters misrepresented CKB as a legitimate and profitable MLM company that sells web-based children's educational courses, when in fact, CKB has little or no retail consumer sales and no apparent source of revenue other than money received from new investors. In an adjudicated settled action, SEC v. Rex Venture Group, the SEC shut down a $600 million fraud that duped approximately 1 million internet customers through a complex investment scam involving a Ponzi scheme promoted as a daily profit share pool and a pyramid scheme pitched as an MLM program for ZeekRewards.com, the self-described affiliate advertising division for Zeekler.com, a penny auction website. The SEC alleged that, for the pyramid scheme component of the scam, the defendants promised bonuses and commissions to customers for enrolling in a monthly subscription plan and recruiting others to join the plan. However, according to the SEC's complaint, new customers' funds were pooled and used to pay recruiting bonuses to existing customers because there was no substantial legitimate revenue from product sales. Protect yourself. Do not let anyone pressure you into making decisions about money or investments. Always get independent financial advice. Be wary of schemes or products that claim a guaranteed income. Consider whether the rewards you have been promised are dependent on product sales. If so, are the products of real value, sold at a reasonable price, and something that there is actually consumer demand for? Remember that family members and friends may try to involve you in a pyramid scheme without realizing that it is one. It is against the law not only to promote a pyramid scheme, but to participate in one. What is your opinion about pyramid scheme scam? Let us know your opinion in the comment section below. This was all for today. Hope you liked the video. Do not forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel. Hit the bell icon for more updates and notifications. Stay safe, and we will be back soon with another video.